All right, so we're going to talk about graphing quadratic functions. Now, a lot of this isn't going to be new to you guys because you've graphed parabolas before, but we are going to add some information. You will be expected to be able to find the vertex of a parabola, the intercepts, which is going to include x-intercepts and y-intercept. There's always one y-intercept. There's not necessarily x-intercepts. And one other point, just to make it a nice graph. We'll talk about that when we get to the graphing portion. And let me think, what else? Oh, something new to you maybe is the axis of symmetry. So we will be drawing that in, and we will be writing its equation. Now, you need to be able to do these things by hand using algebra, and you need to be able to do them using a graphing calculator. So you got to learn both. So we're going to start with your basic function, which we had in unit 1, f of x equals x squared. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to plot some points. And I'm going to make it easy on myself. I'm not even going to the graphing calculator or the table or anything like that. I'm just going to pick some integers and plug them in just to get some nice points. You already kind of know what this thing looks like, right? So how do we get y? Well, we square the x. So negative 2 squared is 4, negative 1 squared is 1, 0 squared is 0, 1 squared is 1, and 2 squared is 4. Everybody good so far? All right, so we're going to plot those points. So negative 2, 4, negative 1, 1, 0, 0, point, 1, 1, and 2, 4. And then we're going to sketch the curve using those points as our guide. So, the thing to notice about a parabola is you take any point, there's going to be another point that's symmetric to it. In this case, symmetric through the y-axis. Okay? Except for one. And what's that called?
The vertex.
The vertex. So, the vertex is this point here. Happens to be the x-intercept on this problem, also the y-intercept on this problem. But the vertex is 0, 0, and that's the only point that doesn't have a match. Every other point has a match at the level, whatever its level of y is. Okay? So everybody remembers that. All right. Now, in Unit 1, you talked about transformations. Remember those? Where you move a graph left, right, up, down, reflected, all that good stuff. All right. So that's the first way we're going to approach these parabolas. So we're going to look at a general form. Now, you guys, for me, you don't need to memorize this form. It's called vertex form. If you took Algebra 2 in high school, then you might have learned it in there. Okay? But we're just going to look at it based on what we learned in Unit 1. So we're going to look at the comparison between this function with the function f of x equals x squared. And think about what the shifts are. So let's start on the inside and work our way out. Do you remember what adding or subtracting something to x does? You don't remember? It's a left or a right. Yeah, if it was negative, it moved it right. If it was positive, it moved it left. And we have to be a little careful mathematically because we don't know whether h is a positive or a negative number. So we don't really know if this is a plus or a minus. But you can think of, remember I gave you this little trick? If you set the expression x minus h equal to 0 and solve it, you see which way it moves. So the x from the vertex would move to the value h. Now, what does the plus k on the outside do? It moves it up. Or if k was negative, it would move it down, right? So we've got it in the formula as plus k, but remember this is going to be a shift up if k is bigger than 0, and it's going to be a shift down if k is less than 0. Okay. So before we even look at A, let's think about the point 0, 0, which is your vertex on y equals x squared. So it starts at 0, 0. Now let's just go ahead to make it easier. Let's say that h is a positive number, and let's say that k is a positive number. Where is the vertex going to move to? Now, let me just put a dashed line just so we can kind of follow where things are moving. Okay? Then where does 0 move to? Well, the x moves h units to the right. So it would move here. And the whole graph would move up k units. So if your vertex moved from here to here and then moved up, where are you now? You're at hk. You see why that's called the vertex form? Because you can just look at that thing and tell me what the vertex is.
Bless you.
You can look at it and say the vertex is the value hk. All right? Now, what does the A do? It can shrink it vertically or stretch it vertically, depending on its comparison with 1.
Bless you.
But what if it's negative?
Shrinks.
If A is negative, what does it do? It reflects it. Which way?
Downward?
Yes, across the x-axis. So if A is less than 0, your parabola is going to open downward. All right? Is that starting to come back to y'all from Unit 1? Mm-hmm. No? Yeah, you may need to review it. You're going to see it on the test again.
The nutrient transformation is about wholeness.
Oh, yeah. Sort of lost on you. Yeah.
Can you make it go back real quick?
Sure.
Thanks. So if the A is greater than 0, what happens?
It would still open upward.
So nothing would change?
Well, if this, let's say it was a 2, that's going to take your points and pull them up faster, right?
Oh, wait.
That's where you get that vertical stretch or shrink. But if it was negative 2, then it's going to stretch it, but it's also going to flip it.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's look at some examples. I think it'll help. This is just kind of in general what's happening. Okay. So that's just writing up what we just talked through. All right. So let's look at this one. This is in vertex form. The reason I can see that is because I have x squared, and then a number on the outside. So here's the only place I see x, and it's inside parentheses squared. So that shows me it's in the vertex form. So tell me whether it opens upward or downward.
Down
because of the negative. Okay, the A value is negative 1. So it reflects downward. What is the vertex? Give me the x.
4.
Give me the y. 3. Remember the form. Go back to the form. Well, actually, let me write it right here. Somebody really tall put these boards up. Because I'm not really that short. There's your form, right? X minus h squared plus k. So, this is a positive 4 and a positive 3. Now, this is something we didn't talk about yet, the line of symmetry. So let's go back. All right, the line of symmetry for your basic graph is the y-axis. We talked about that back in Unit 1, that you had symmetry to the y-axis. So the line of symmetry gets shifted, and where does it get shifted to? It gets shifted to wherever that vertex is. So it's going to be at the vertical line that goes through the vertex. So let's write that in your notes. And that's one of those things to kind of put a little star by, because that's a good thing to study before test two and again before the final. All right. How do we get line of symmetry? It is the vertical line through the vertex. So what is it for this parabola in particular?
Four.
Now remember, don't just say four. You got to say x equals four, because if you just tell me four, I don't know if you understand that that's a vertical line. If you put y equals four, that's a horizontal line. Okay, so you've got to say this has to be included because it's the equation of a line. Anytime you give an equation of a line, you got to either have an x or a y or both. Okay? Okay, now we're adding a little tiny bit more to this. And this, Tuesday. Thursday, we're going to be working on word problems, and they're all going to be based on parabolas. And so what we're talking about here is going to be important for probably 80% of your questions. Okay? Does the function have a maximum or a minimum?
Yeah, maximum.
Maximum, he says. Okay?
As a minimum.
Let's go with the picture, okay? What we're gonna do is draw a rough sketch of what you guys have told me already. Now I haven't found any intercepts. We'll worry about that in a little while because I don't want to do too much all at once. But let's plot that vertex. And so we're not gonna worry about specific points down here on the x-axis right now. But remember, you told me that it opens downward. So does anybody want to change their answer? Does it have a maximum or a minimum?
Maximum.
It has a maximum. It has a highest value, right? Remember, when you say max or min, that's referring to the function values, which are the y values. So it definitely has a maximum. So let's just circle maximum. And what is the maximum? It is 3, yes. And you don't have to say why in that case, but your correct answer is 3. It occurs at, to be clear, x equals 4. And some of your questions will make you answer that way. But when you're asked for a max or min, it is always a y value. You're saying what the maximum or minimum function value is. So what you'll see in the problems that we do on Thursday is we're going to maximize profit, minimize cost, things like that. Okay? Does anybody have a question at this point? All right. I'm not going to make you complete the square in this section, by the way. You only have to do that once on the test, but you have to do it. Okay, so when you're working in your homework, first thing to look at is, are they giving me this equation in the vertex form? That's the one I want to relate back to the transformations. So remember that this was vertex form. It is not going to be necessary for you to multiply this out. Okay? So try to remember that. Look at your notes side by side when you're doing your homework and go, okay, that one's in the vertex form. So it's pretty easy to pick out what the vertex is and what else is going on. Yes?
And if not in the vertex form,
okay, that's the next thing we're going to do. Okay. Because I'm not going to make you complete the square. All right? College algebra, in a way, is kind of in between Algebra 1 and Algebra 2. In Algebra 2, we would be completing the square in order to get our parabola in vertex form. So somebody might want to try that just for kicks. Yes?
Thank you.
Okay. All right. So now we'll talk about what you do if it's not in vertex form. So one option would be to rewrite it in the verb text form, and you'd have to use completing the square to do that. But like I said, we're not going to do that. If we did, we could work with, this is called standard form, and we could do some fancy algebra and show how to change this form into the vertex form. And if we did all that, you would see where the vertex formula comes from. All right? So if you're somebody who just can't get past working with problems unless you understand them from the ground up, I strongly recommend that you go and figure that out. Or come to my office. I'd be glad to go through it with you. I'm going to just give you the formula, and I want you to memorize it. So, to find the x-coordinate of the vertex, you use this formula. Minus b over 2a. I'm getting the a and the b from the square term and from the linear term. Do be careful with this denominator. I will often see people make mistakes because they type things into their calculator wrong. So either calculate it ahead of time or put parentheses around it. I just want to show you something. Show you how easy, once you know the quadratic formula, how easy it is to learn the vertex formula. Do you see it?
Yeah.
It's this part. Okay? It's just that part. So once you know the quadratic formula, you can remember the formula for finding the x coordinate, just the first coordinate of the vertex, is minus b over 2a. Now, there is a formula for finding the y-coordinate, but it's very complicated. So what's a better way once we know x?
Plug it in.
Plug it in. Okay. Plug it in. So you're just going to plug in this x value into your formula. That's easier. So, if you need to, make another note card on that because you've got to memorize quadratic formula. You got to memorize how to do the process of completing the square method. That might be something you want on a card. And you've got to remember the vertex formula. I will give you a problem where I ask you to use that. On some problems, it'll be your choice. You can either use the formula or you can use your calculator with the graphing features. But on one problem, I will say, use this. Okay? You ready? I'm going to practice. All right. So, we're going to do all the whole thing on this one. We're going to do by hand. Give the line of symmetry, the vertex, the maximum, and min, and we're going to graph by hand. So, in standard form. It's not in vertex form. So I'm going to use that little formula with the a value 1 and the b value 2. We're plugging into minus b over 2a. So that is minus 2. Over 2 times 1. Now, you would not mess it up on this one if you didn't do your order of operations correctly, but remember, it's better to go ahead and multiply that out. 2 times 2. 2 times 1 is 2. And so, negative 1 is the x value. Am I going too fast? Now we're going to find y. So So I'm going to plug in for the x's. Negative 1 squared plus 2 times negative 1 plus 6. Remember, in real numbers, if you square a number, you always get a positive. If you were using your calculator on this one, make sure you put parentheses around a negative if you want it squared. Negative 1 squared is 1. 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. Plus 6. And I get 5. Is that what you guys are getting? Okay, 5. Okay, now this is the other thing, is make sure you write down the vertex as a point. It is the point negative 1, 5. So let's plot it. Negative 1, 5 is right there. Which way should this parabola open?
Up.
Should open up, yes. Which means what about x-intercepts? If it opens up from there,
it doesn't have them.
It doesn't have them. So if I tried to use my calculator to help me, well, it's not going to do any good, right? Because there aren't any. If I wanted to find out what the zeros are, what would they be? Say you're going to use a quadratic formula. What kind of answers are you going to come out with if it doesn't cross the x-axis?
Is it positive?
No, because it won't cross, right?
So zero.
Not zero.
No,
zero's here. Well, in unit one, we would have said no solution.
But it has this
complex numbers. Remember? We talked about that the other day. You would get I. Alright? Remember I showed you with your calculator that you could check yourself by saying, oh, if I graph this thing, it doesn't cross the x-axis. And so I should be getting complex solutions with the quadratic formula. Okay? That's why I didn't ask us to find them on this one. Alright, so we've got our vertex. Now, let me show you. On this problem, we're only going to do 3 points. Normally, we're going to do 5. If it has x-intercepts that are easy to plot, we're going to plot them. So let's remember how to find the y-intercept, because I wanted to do this whole thing without using a calculator. How do I find the y-intercept? What is a y-intercept? What does that mean?
Crosses y.
Crosses the y-axis. So what value do you always know on the y-axis? 0, 4, x, right? If I plug in 0 for x, notice which number I'm going to come up with. Yep. Is that always going to happen? Am I always going to get that the c value is the y-intercept if it's in standard form? Yes, because that's going to turn to 0, that's going to turn to 0. So c is always the value where it crosses the y-axis. So that's the point 0, 6, which we're going to plot. And then I'm going to show you something else really nice and easy. But does anybody have a question? Did I go over your head or talk too fast? Where are intercepts? They're where the other variable is 0. So the y-intercept is where x is 0. We good with that?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Then let's plot that one. It'd be right here. Now, let's plot the axis of symmetry. We're also going to write its equation. X equals negative 1. We're going to point out that this is the vertex. I like you to label these things. We're going to point out that that is the y-intercept. We can abbreviate. Okay, that's the y-intercept. Now, without having to use a table and thinking about symmetry, do you guys know another point that you could plot?
Negative
2, 6. Why? Because of the symmetry. Everybody see that? So whenever you graph the y-intercept, you automatically know another point. Just go that same distance across the axis of symmetry and plot it, and you got it. Okay? I don't mean to rhyme all the time, by the way. Okay? Just kind of happens. So on this problem, we're just going to do those three. We're not going to do five. On another one, we'll do five. Yes. Yes. Which means you will have x-intercepts. Okay? Does that make you sad?
Could it be complex numbers?
There could be, but I want a nice parabola where you have to plot 5 points, so probably not. Okay? Nobody has any questions? Everybody feels good about this. They know how to graph all this.
If it's not in the standard form, in order to find the y-intercept, you have to turn it into standard form?
Very good question. Let's go back and do that on the other one, because I don't remember if you have to do that in your homework. So let's do that together. It's actually a little more complicated. The question, just to make sure everybody heard, is if it was in the vertex form, what do we do to find the x-intercept? It's easy, but it's not quite as easy, because with standard form, it's just this number, right? It's going to be zero, that number. But let's go back to the one I had. Didn't I have one here? There, that one right there. Okay, I'm just going to add in an extra page here, so y'all help me remember what the formula says, and we will look at that. So tell me if I'm writing it wrong. Is that right? Is that it?
Yeah.
All right. How do we find the y-intercept? Plug in x equals 0. But see, you're going to have to make a calculation, right? That's the difference. So it's the opposite of whatever this is. So negative 4 squared plus 3. So it's the opposite of 16 plus 3, which is negative 13. So that y-intercept was 0, negative 13.
So you just plug in 0.
For x to get the y-intercept. So this was finding the y-intercept. Now, since you asked, I'm glad she asked, by the way, you guys, because you've got a graphing problem where you're going to have to do this. So let's go ahead and find the x-intercepts, too, for this one. How do we find x-intercepts?
By using the formula you just gave us.
Well, but what is an x-intercept? It's where the graph crosses the x-axis. So what is it that's 0?
1.
Yes. So let's see what our x-intercepts are. We're going to plug in 0 for the y. Now, there are a few students who would be tempted to multiply that thing out and solve it. But that's the whole reason we learned the square root method. Because look, can I just add that to the other side? Mm-hmm. Everybody see what I'm doing? Do you see it?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's add this whole expression to both sides. The reason I'm doing that is I want to isolate the square, so I don't want that negative in front of it. Okay? And then what? How do we solve that equation? Square root method. Ooh, this one isn't nice, is it? So I'd have to use a calculator on this one if I was going to graph. Okay. But I do think you guys have a homework where you have to do this. So I'm very glad you asked. Okay. So here are the x-intercepts. They are 4 plus the square root of 3, comma 0. That's one of them. And 4 minus the square root of 3 is the other one. That's exact value, and if I'm not mistaken, in the homework they ask you for the exact value on those. If they wanted an approximation, then you just type in 4 plus square root of 3 and approximate to whatever number of decimals. Okay? So, very good. So, y-intercept, we plug in 0 for x. x-intercepts, we plug in 0 for y, and we usually have more to do there. We have to solve somehow. What are our methods of solving? If it factors, we factor. What are the other two methods?
Quadratic.
Yeah, quadratic. Square root method. Right. Has everybody got what they need on this page? Okay. We threw in something extra there, which is a good thing. Me when you're ready. You guys ready? All right. So let's look at this one. We're going to find the intercepts, which means all three of them if there are two x-intercepts. The vertex and the line of symmetry, we're going to draw the graph including these points and enough for a total of 5, which is what I will be asking you to do on the test. I want all of that information. Some of it you're going to do completely use. I mean, you can use the calculator to assist you, but I'm going to want to see all the algebra, okay? So let's do the vertex first. For the vertex, I need that a is negative 1 and b is 3. Everybody see where I get those from? You okay on that? All right. So we're using minus b over 2a. Now, of course, you can check it on your calculator, right? Make sure you did it right. So that is 3 over 2 times negative 1. There's 2 negatives, so that's 3 halves. Now, I'm going to plug it in that way. If I have an online problem, I would plug in 3 halves for the x. But if I'm graphing, of course, I need to know where that is, and that's 1.5. I don't think your online program will accept 1.5. Okay, so now to find the y value for the vertex, we're going to plug in.
So you want to keep it in 3 over 2 for the homework?
Yes. Okay, it's not that I want it, but that's the way the program wants
it's okay.
it. Pretty sure. Okay, now when I say do it by hand, I don't mean you can't use your calculator at all. You've shown me that you're finding the y, so it's okay with me if you want the calculator to do the fraction work for you. So let's do that. Has everybody got it written down so you can help me type it in the calculator?
Yes.
All right. You ready? So we're going to do the opposite of 3 over 2 squared. Is that correct?
Yes.
And then we need a plus.
Plus.
Is it 3? What's the next number?
3.
3 times 3 over 2. And then what's the last number?
4. Plus 4.
Plus 4. Okay. Remember your fraction key if you go to math. Enter, enter. If it's a fraction answer, then it's going to come out to the fraction. So it's 25/4. So the vertex is 3/2. 25/4. Now, to be able to graph that, and I won't be quite this mean to you with all these fractions to graph, okay, on the test, but that's 1.5 and 6.25, is that right?
Yep.
Okay. So there's the vertex. So somewhere on your paper, you're labeling that that's the vertex for me. Okay, so 1.5, 6.25 is about right there. y-intercept. That's easy. What's the y-intercept? And you don't have to show me the work on this one. Just tell me what it is. 0, 4. Okay, so let's plot that. Let's go ahead and draw the axis of symmetry and write its equation, which would be what? X equals 1.5 or 3/2. Either one is correct. Okay, let's go ahead and do that matching point. Even though this is a fraction, you guys can do that, right? This point is 1.5 to the left. So what point's going to be 1.5 to the right?
3.
Okay, it'll be a 3. 4. And this one was at 0, 4. This is labeling. When we say label, that's what we mean. Write down what the points are. You know, use words. Use your words. Okay. And one thing left to do, right? Find the intercepts. Is this one going to have intercepts? X-intercepts? It certainly is, because it's opening, we can see by our points already, it's opening downwards, so there will be two x-intercepts. And so to find the x-intercepts, I've got to solve the equation that finds the zeros. I don't like the leading term to be negative, so I'm going to multiply 3 by -1. And you guys tell me, does this one factor? What do you say? Don't fall asleep on me.
Yes.
Yes. What does it factor as? Well, remember, you got to get 4, right? Check. -4, +1, works. Okay. So 4, -1, do not write those as a point. That's wrong. The points are 4, 0, and -1, 0. Those were x values, not y values. And then we're going to plot those, and we are done with this pretty picture. Okay. And that is what you're expected to be able to do. Now, I do have a couple word problems that come at the end of the notes on this. We're going to be working on that on Thursday, as well as other word problems. It's your last section in Unit 2. So do bring those notes. What were they? 4 and -1. Oops. Do all those points make sense?
Yes.
Okay. They are spaced correctly. There's a complete picture. I would write that that is 4, 0, and that this is -1, 0.
Miss, can you scroll down one more time?
Sure.
The
okay, before I scroll, does everybody have what they need up here so I don't make people dizzy? Okay. So where I got my X's?
Yeah.
Okay. And we're going to work on the graphing assignment now, which I hope the people at home will do as